हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न फेवरहाउस की रीअरेंजमेंट. द रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्फा हैलो कीटोन्स कंटेनिंग एन अल्फा हाइड्रोजन ऑन नॉन हैलोजिनेटेड साइड ऑफ द कार्बोनिल विथ एल्कोक्साइड आयोन्स गिव रीअरेंज्ड एस्टर विच इज कॉल्ड फेवरहाउस की रीअरेंजमेंट. फेवरहाउस की रीअरेंजमेंट इज सिमिलर टू स्टीवन्स रीअरेंजमेंट, नेबर रीअरेंजमेंट and Wittig rearrangement, because all the four have one thing in common, that is it is a rearrangement to an electron rich carbon atom. So that is one thing we should know. The mechanism involves a cyclopropanone derivative 2 which is formed by the internal SN2 displacement of the halide ion by an initially formed carbanion. Base then adds to the cyclopropanone carbonyl and the ring opening takes place in a way to give more stable carbanions. So let us look at the mechanism. So here the substrate is an alpha halo ketone. So here you can see it is an alpha halo ketone, and the criteria is that the hydrogen, that is the alpha hydrogen, should be present away from the halogens. So you can see here the alpha hydrogen is present away from the halogen, only then the rearrangement can take place. So this is the first criteria. So now let us look at the rearrangement. First we have an alkoxide. So here there is the methoxide, which is a good base, is going to deprotonate the hydrogen, alpha hydrogen. Once it is deprotonating, we know once the H plus is removed, there is going to be a negative charge on the carbon, which becomes a carbon electron rich carbon. So that is why you can say that Fevorowski rearrangement is a rearrangement involving the electron, is a rearrangement to the electron rich carbon atom. So now there is a intermediate one which is having a carb anion, which is present here. Now this undergoes a rearrangement in such a way that the negative charge on the carbon atom forms a cyclopropane ring. So now once it is an SN2 reaction, so we know SN2 is a concerted nucleophilic reaction. It is nothing but nucleophilic substitution reaction of the order 2. So here you can see that the lone pair on the carbon forms, or the negative charge, the nucleophile attacks the carbon having the, which is bonded to the chlorine, and the Cl minus is departed. So it is a concerted reaction and it is the SN2 reaction. So now once this happens, you can see there is a formation of a cyclopropanone ring intermediate, as an intermediate which is formed. The cyclopropanone intermediate is formed. Now after the cyclopropanone intermediate is formed, what happens is the methoxide, which is already present in the reaction medium, again attacks the carbonyl carbon, and then the double bond between carbon and oxygen moves towards oxygen to give a negative charge on the oxygen. So once the cyclopropanone intermediate is formed, the OCH3- alkoxide ion attacks the carbonyl carbon, you can see, and the double bond between carbon and oxygen moves towards the oxygen to give rise to a negative charge on the oxygen. Now here, at this point, what happens? The negative charge on oxygen comes back to form a double bond, that is to give back a carbonyl group, and then there is the ring opening. The cyclopropanone ring, we know, is a strain molecule because it is having a angular strain. So because of which the ring has to be opened. So that is how this intermediate step is taking place. That is, the negative charge on oxygen comes back to form a double bond to give the carbonyl, and there is a ring opening. So now here the question comes, how the ring is going to open. So the ring opening will happen in such a way that there is a stable carbanion which is formed. Means the carbanion which is generated should be stabilized by conjugation or by resonance. So in your reaction, suppose you are getting confused on which end the carbanion is or the ring opening is happening, then make sure that wherever there is a conjugation of that negative charge, there is the stability of the carbanion. So this is one thing that we should remember. See, for example, groups like methyl, amine, so these will destabilize the negative charge, because we know methyl provides press inductive effect, amine is also gives the electron donating effect. So these will never stabilize the negative charge. Instead, they will provide a negative charge to a further extent. So we need a group like an electron withdrawing group, or we need a group like a phenyl group, or that's a benzyl group, which will release the negative charge through conjugation. So this is one thing which you should remember. So whenever you're whenever there's a ring opening of the cyclopropanone ring, make sure that there is a proper substituent, and it should be stabilized by resonance or by conjugation, or at least there should be an electron withdrawing group so that the negative charge will be stabilized. So now here in this, if you see, so there are two possibilities of how the ring opening can take place. That is, one is on the left side, you can see, and one is on the right side, which you can see here. So now the more possibility is the one which we are taking it on the right side. Means the ring opening is going to take place on your right side. That is, this arrow mark, that is, this carbon atom is going to get cleaved, because it is going to give a better carb anion compared to the left side. So that is what you should compare. So now after this negative charge has been obtained here, the last step is nothing but the hydrolysis. So the negative charge, that is a base, would, there's a base which is already present here, that is CH3OH, that is nothing but the methanol, is going to give back the H plus to the carb anion to give rise to the formation of the product. So this is how the reaction takes place. So that's nothing but the alpha haloketone, which is the substrate, on reaction with a base would give rise to the product, which is an ester. So this is the reaction of the Feverovsky rearrangement. Now this is another similar example which is given here. So here also you can see the first the first step, that is the formation, or that is the deprotonation of the alpha hydrogen and formation of cyclopropanone, is common for usually, and you can just write down it directly. There's no need of any more of thinking. But the next step, which involves the formation of the carb anion, this one you should think, and you should write down on which end the cyclopropanone ring is breaking, and the carb anion should be stabilized. So here you can see that CH2 minus is more stable here, because if you do the other way round, that is, the if you remove the, or if the ring opening is taking place on the left side, what happens is there is a methyl group and there's a negative charge, which is which you can say that it is not a good or it is not a stable carb anion. So we have to look for the more stable carb anion. So hence we are going to take up this side, that is nothing but the ring opening is going to take place on the right side, and then the carb anion is formed. Now the last step would be in presence of the alcohol. So in presence of the alcohol, that is the methanol, it is going to give up, it is going to give one proton to the carb anion, and you are going to get the final product, which is nothing but the formation of the ester. Feverovsky reaction involves the formation of cyclopropanones as the intermediates. The formation of such intermediates has been clearly established. Example 2,3-diet-tertiary-butyl-cyclopropanone, which is somewhat unreactive towards base, has been isolated from the reaction of the corresponding alpha-chloroketone with potassium hydroxide. So this is, you can say, it is a proof to say that the cyclopropanone ring is formed. So they can ask for 2 marks this kind of questions. How do you, what would be the intermediate, how do you assured that there is a cyclopropanone ring which is formed in Feverovsky rearrangement, then you can just you can write down this point. Next we have one more example, a similar kind of example. It is a, so here you can see that 1 and 2 are the isomers here, and you can see the product which are formed is the same in on reaction with a mild base. And here you can see the reactions which is going on here. There is the first formation, deprotonation from of the alpha hydrogen from the methoxide, alkoxide, that's methoxide, and there's a formation of the cyclopropanone. The next step would be the ring opening, that is, the cyclopropanone will be cleaved, and you can see on left side is the more stable benzylic carbanion, on the right side there's a less stable. So here you can say it is more stable, because you can see here you have a phenyl group and you have a negative charge carbanion. So the negative charge will be continuous movement or delocalization of the negative charge, and because of which the benzylic carbanion is more stable than the other carbanion which is formed here, because here the negative charge is only concentrated and it is not getting delocalized. So this way you can find out and write down the which way the bond is being broken, that is the cyclopropanone ring is being broken, and then you can write down the product. So the in case of cyclic compounds, what happens is there, you should know that in Favreau's rearrangement, if there is a four-membered ring, it will come down to three-membered ring. There is no homologous reactions taking place here, but it is going to be a step-down reaction. There's going to be one carbon atom less than the substrate. So this one thing you should remember in your mind, because you can see here it is an example for Favreau's scheme. You have an alpha halo ketone and you have a base. And if they ask the product in a form of a question mark or anything like that, then you can easily make out that it is a Favreau's rearrangement and the final product would be a cyclopropanone derivative. And here you have a six-membered substrate, which would give rise to a five-membered ring. So this is how the, and this is the mechanism for that. So first step we know is always the deprotonation of the alpha hydrogen. So this is going to be the alpha hydrogen. This is the alpha hydrogen. So this is going to be deprotonated. And here you can see the formation of a negative charge. And negative charge will, through SN2 reaction mechanism, concerted mechanism, is going to form here. You can see lone pair forms a bond between the carbon atom and Cl- is departing. And you can see how there is already the formation of a five-membered ring here. There's a bicyclic ring. There's a 5,1 bicyclic ring formed here. 3,1 bicyclic ring which is formed here. And the next step would be OCH3- would attack the carbonyl carbon. Is the same mechanism. And O- is formed. And then again the negative charge on oxygen comes back to form a double bond, and there is the ring opening. So once the ring opening is taking place, you can see how there is a formation of a five-membered ring. And the last step would be the nothing but the hydrolysis. We are going to, in presence of the methanol, we are going to get a five-membered ester which is formed. So this is the mechanism for a cyclic Favreau's rearrangement. Thank you.